Remaining at her terrace rail, the chocolate raven lights a cigarette, pours a final glass of wine, and lets her face sink into her hands with her eyes closed. The air is heating fast as the morning sun slides up another busy city day. The night is gone entirely, and now that it's gone, she can see a truth that she hates and despises with a vengeance as soon as she catches sight of it. In effect, she's seeing the nature of the same great lie that she half-glimpsed on the occasion when she drove to the mad-faced tower. Then she had the option of postponing apprehension by burying her head between her knees on the back seat and wailing to the driver to drive away at high speed. Now she doesn't have that choice. It's too late, for now she's seen too clearly what nobody deserves to see. What this knowledge comes down to, in her case at this moment, is that when she lifts her head again, then not only will her visions a minute ago of Scorpio and the platinum raven in the sky have both vanished in the glare of day, but the mad-faced tower will have disappeared from the rock slopes too, with what she recognises as a senseless but inevitable fuck-up that she should have seen coming. No more amber, no more Scorpio, and no more platinum raven. And maybe this will sound strange, or maybe it will not, but either way, this freight of brand new but familiar knowledge leaves her miserably desolate.